To you, O blessed Trinity, be glory and honor forever and ever. Amen. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the community of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our brother Ronald. We thank you for giving him to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see that death has been swallowed up in the victory of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that we may live in confidence and hope until by your call we are gathered to our heavenly home in the company of all your saints. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. And I have a prayer from Immanuel Lutheran Church. Let us pray. And let us remember her and her family today as we have this service for Ron. Loving God, we know that life is full of difficulties, and that when we lean on you to help us journey through our grief, things are a bit easier. This afternoon, we acknowledge the loss of Penelope, and we pray that her soul will rest eternally with you. We pray for her family, that their grief will be consoled by your presence, knowing that it is through Jesus that we have our sorrows softened. God, we know that we will never totally get over the loss of our parents, but healing does take place, and it does get easier. We give you thanks for your healing presence. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Before me, in the presence of my enemies, were baptized into his death. Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The word of the Lord.
I've seen hard times, and I have been told it isn't any wonder that I fall. Why do we suffer? Be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you unto myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe in me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. The Word of God.
Praise you, Lord Christ.
We are gathered to glorify God as we celebrate the life of Ron Cooper. And I wish that I could have known him, because from what I have been told, Ron was a faithful servant of God in the way that he treated people during his life. And the way that he died was far less than what he deserved. However, Ron is now going to be in his rightful place, in the presence of God. As we journey through this life, we find so many difficulties. You know, some of them center around money, some of them jobs, home life, children, parents, our health, loneliness and depression, grief, and sometimes it's just a combination of many things, and we don't feel as though we are able to withstand the pressures of life. People may find many ways to cope with them. Some are not so healthy, like recreational drugs, but many of the coping ways are healthy. Yoga, exercise, deep breathing, and prayer. When we bring God into our lives through prayer, we find that even though we are still experiencing the pressures, they don't seem as difficult to handle, not like they once were. The burden lifts a little because it's shared. Jesus said, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. When the journey of life is over, as Ron's is, Jesus has promised us that there is room for us where he is, near God the Father. Jesus wants us to not be afraid of death, because it is not the end. It is just the beginning of a new life. And he promises a place for us in his Father's house. The way to get there is through Jesus, because he is the way, the truth, and the life. When we obey Jesus, we can invite the Holy Spirit to dwell within us. And the Holy Spirit will guide us on our journey, keeping us in tune with God's will for our lives. Jesus has promised not to leave us orphaned. And for those of us who have lost both of our parents, that is a comforting statement. Jesus will not leave us orphaned. We not only have the comforter of the Holy Spirit here with us on earth, but we will be reunited with our loved ones once our earthly journey is over. Jesus leaves his peace with us. It is not the peace as the world looks at peace. It is the peace in knowing that no matter what comes our way, we do not have to face it alone. Jesus is with us. The Holy Spirit guides us, and the Father is waiting to unite us. The 23rd Psalm, as we read together earlier, is also a reminder that we will pass through difficulty, but we are not alone, that we have the rod and the staff of knowing God, that God has prepared a table for us where we can eat safe and secure, even though we know our enemies are watching over us, because God is with us. And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Ron is with God in the house of the Lord. And from what Ron and Connie, from what Connie and her daughters and Paige said about Ron, he was a very loving man, one who took care to make sure that everyone had everything they needed to be comfortable. He was a kind and patient man, a joy to be around. I'm told he told lots of jokes, that he was a goulash guru and the barbecue king, that he loved to relax with them, and that he didn't often get mad, and he never complained. That if he didn't have what you wanted, he thought nothing of taking a run to get it. And I think you probably all know how Ron and Connie got together, that they had gone to school together, and Connie was living in Rochester, but was back in town to visit her mom when she ran into Ron in the store. And the three of them went out to eat. Whenever Connie would visit her mom, the three of them would go out to eat. Until one time, her mom said she just didn't feel like eating out. The two of them go. And Connie proposed to Ron at the wharf. And the rest is history. He was always good to Connie, and it was tragic the way his life ended. But he is at peace now, eating and drinking at table with Jesus. No more pain. No more sorrow, no more difficulties. And even though Ron is gone, his memory lives on in each of you, and so does his love. I have come to believe that love continues even after our mortal bodies are gone. So rest assured that his love surrounds you, each and every one of you, until we meet again. Amen. Would anyone else like to say a word about Ron? I'm sure that allowed you time to think of memories of Ron. Praise be to God. Oh, okay. You should probably stand.
Yeah. upstairs, came in through the bedroom. And I was just focused on the TV. I don't even remember what was on. And he's walking like this. And it still went over my head and just focused on the television. The bed is here, the TV is on an angle here, and he goes walking through me, and he crosses my path. He had, I don't know what he had, some kind of a hat, a big dumb hat, and he had it on his head. He had his parka on, and he had it clutched like this, and he's glaring at me because he's being goofy. Like this. And he's staring at me the whole time. He comes around the bed. Didn't take his eyes off of me once. As he came around this way and looked at me. He sat down and he put his head back one leg and the other leg. He had his big hunting boots on. We tried to figure out how long it was we left. We were in pain. It was so funny, and he always would catch me unaware. He just, I missed that laugh. I miss everything.